Hi, my name is Thomas Maurer. I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. And in today's video, we are going to have a look how you can automatically start and shut down Azure virtual machines using automation tasks. This will help you to actually save costs and you only pay for Azure virtual machines when you're actually running them. So here we are in the Azure portal, and I already selected my Azure virtual machine I want to do, create like auto shutdown and auto start tasks. So you're probably familiar with the traditional way of doing that. So under operations, you can find a menu item called auto shutdown. And again, this will let you do what it says. It lets you basically configure an automatic shutdown for your Azure VM. And I think that is great, especially if you want to save some money, right? So if you're running the virtual machine, it only needs you running during daytime and you don't need it during the night, you can actually save cost by shutting that VM down because of the pay-per-use model we have in Azure. So that is a great feature. However, sometimes I also want to use automatic start, right? And I don't have a button here which allows me to do automatic start options. However, what we have is something called automation tasks. So if I scroll down and to the automation section here, I can see here I have a menu item called tasks. And you will see that for many different Azure resources already available. Again, it's currently in preview, but this allows me to create some automation tasks. And now you can see here for that specific Azure resource, I haven't really configured anything. So what I can do here is I can click on add task, and then I get a couple of different templates depending on the resource I'm managing. So since this is a virtual machine, next to just sending me monthly costs for this specific resource, I can also set up auto start for that virtual machine or schedule a start for that virtual machine, as well as also a power off state. So what I want to do here is let's first create a shutdown or a power off state for that machine because it's currently running. I'm going to select that. And what I need to do basically is I need to connect my environment here. So I need to have a specific login to my Azure environment as well as my Office 365 environment to actually send out the emails. So in this case, I'm just going to do that and say create account. And we'll see here, I need to sign in with my account here. And I can then do the same here for my Office 365 account. Because it's using my user context to actually do this, right? So the next thing I want to do is obviously start do the configuration for the power off of the virtual machine. So now I'm on the configuration task, so I can change the task name to, for example, let's say the name of the VM and then off. That sounds like a good idea. I can then configure when is the stop time and say, okay, I want to do that, for example, let's say do that first day, 12 a.m. I can also select obviously the time zone I'm running that. So in my case, I'm going to pick like, so let's say Central Europe standard time. And then here I can configure the interval, like how many times. And then like, for example, let's say I want to do that every single day, or I want to do that just every week, for example. So for my site, that would be daily. And then I can also say, hey, please notify me. And then I enter my email address here so I get notified. So with that, I'm just gonna create that task. And now you can see here that my automation task is created and scheduled. I will also be able to see like the runs here. So for example, if I click on run, I will be able to see the run times when that specific task was running. So I can actually see if something, when something goes wrong or didn't get an email or whatever, I can see actually why, what happened to that. I can also go and, for example, modify that specific task. So I can say, do that inline, which means it gives me just the same wizard as before. Or I can open that up in Logic Apps, because an automation task is nothing else than actually a Logic App task or workflow, if you will. So I can open that up here. So it created that automatically for me. And then if I go to, for example, the Logic App Designer, I can actually see what is happening here. And I could even go out and modify this. So I could work with these settings here. For example, I could go and do some changes to that specific task. I could also add some additional information. So if I want to, for example, add other VMs, I could then also take that basically as a template to do that. Or if I want to add some information to it, I can do that as well. So now I created obviously the shutdown or the power off task for that virtual machine. If I want to do that now for example, like the automatic start, I could also go back and add obviously another task here. I would select start virtual machine, and you can see here, obviously the accounts are already connected. So I can say configure, I can select the date when it should start. And obviously I don't want that at 10 a.m. Let's say I want to start that at like 8 a.m. Again, I can provide the time zone I just used. So if I can find it, I will select the same one, but let's just say we take North Asia East Standard Time to actually start that machine. And again, I want that, for example, maybe, let's say this time I want just the VM to be started every like Monday, because I'm working every Monday morning with it. And I know that that is when I'm actually working with it. So I'm just gonna say, okay, do that weekly. But then change that obviously to, let's say, Monday. So now it would open, like start the virtual machine every Monday, and then it would shut it down every night. So even if, for example, on Tuesday, if I haven't used it, virtual machine is not running, it would just leave the VM in shutdown mode. However, if during Tuesday, I kind of like needed it on request, so I started up the virtual machine, but I forgot to stop it, the turn off task would still absolutely work fine here. So I can also then go and create that one. And so you can now see I have these scheduled tasks or these automation tasks here ready for that. I hope this video gave you an overview on how you can leverage automation tasks and logic apps to automatically start and stop your Azure virtual machines to save costs. If you liked that video, please give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Thank you.